Hello guys, so today we are going to cover some important questions from the topic depositories. So these questions are very important for our SEBI Grade A examination. So guys, do subscribe to our channel if you like this video. So let us see the first question. Two statements regarding owner of securities in depository system have been given below. Which of the following two statements are correct? So before reading the question further, I would like to explain you about the ownership in case of depository system. So you can understand it like this. So before depository system, there was a company and there was an investor. So the investor was the owner in the books of the company. Simple. But after the depository system has been introduced, now there are three parties: company, depository and the final investor. So now depository is the registered owner in the books of the company and the investor is the beneficial owner in the books of the depository. So depository is the registered owner in the books of the company and investor is a beneficial owner in the books of the depository, right? So now read the question. Statement 1, depository is the registered owner in the records of issuer company. So this statement is right, as I just told you that in the depository system, depository is the registered owner in the books of the company. And statement number 2, investor is the beneficial owner in the records of depository. So this statement is also correct, as we have just seen. So the correct option is option C. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Now next question, question 2, which of the following statements is incorrect? So before reading out the statements, I would like to tell you that chapter 3 of the Depositories Act 1996, so they contain sections 4 to 17 which deal with the rights and obligations of depositories, depository participants, issuers and beneficial owners. So these statements are taken from the chapter 3 only. Now let us read the first statement. Beneficiary owner can pledge his or her securities without informing the depository. So first of all, you need to know, what do we mean by pledge? What is pledge? So basically promoters, they can take loans by pledging their securities. So pledging means basically keeping your securities as collateral to avail loan, right? So beneficiary owner can pledge their securities, but they have to inform the depository. So this statement is wrong because they have to inform the depository. Statement B, every depository is required to maintain a register of beneficial owners. So this statement is right, as I have told you in the previous question. So company maintains a record of registered owners, which is the depository, and depository maintains records of beneficial owners, which are the final investors. So company maintains record of registered owner and depository maintains record of beneficial owner. So this statement is right. Now statement C, all the benefits like voting rights, dividend rights vest with the beneficial owner and not the registered owner. So this statement is also very obvious. So this is also right. Why? Because as I've just told you, so since investor is the ultimate owner or the beneficial owner, so all the benefits, corporate benefits like voting rights, dividend rights, they should also remain with the investor only, because depository is merely acting as an intermediary in this case. It is just acting as a link between the company and the investor. So statement C is also correct. And statement D, beneficial owner can opt out of a depository in respect of any security only after informing the depository. So this statement is correct. So as per section 14 of the Depositories Act 1996, a beneficial owner can opt out of a depository mode at any time, but after informing the depository. And also the issuer company, so the issuer company is also obliged to issue certificate of securities to the beneficial owner within 30 days of receiving information from the depository. So when the depository informs the company that the beneficial owner wants to opt out of the depository mode, so in that case company will have to issue certificate of securities within 30 days to the investor, right? Now moving to the next question. Consider the below table. Column 1 contains forms and parts of various schedules of SEBI, Depositories and Participants Regulations 2018. So SEBI issued regulations in 2018 for depositories and depository participants, DPs. So first of all, if an applicant wants to register as a depository, then it needs to file an application in Form A to SEBI. So Form A is for application for registration, right? And if SEBI satisfied that the applicant is eligible to be registered as a depository, then it will issue certificate of registration in Form B. So grant of certificate of registration. Then within 1 year of the issue of certificate of registration, the applicant has to apply for certificate of commencement of business. So certificate of commencement of business. So the application needs to be made in Form C. And again, if SEBI is satisfied that the person is eligible to be granted certificate of commencement of business, so it will grant the certificate in Form D. So grant of certificate of commencement of business. Now next, there is Part A of second schedule. So it talks about the various registration, application and annual fees payable by depositories and depository participants. And next, Part D of third schedule. So it deals with the code of conduct to be followed by a depository. So code of conduct. So now let us see. So we are given a table. So we have to match the two columns. So first of all, Form A of first schedule. So we have already discussed. It is related to application for registration as a depository. So A and 2, right? Next, Form C. So this is for application for certificate of commencement. So B and 4. Now Part D of third schedule. So this is related to the code of conduct to be followed by depository. So C 3. And next, Part A of second schedule. So I've just told you it is related to the various fees, application fees, registration fees. So this is first. D is related to first. So application, registration and annual fees payable by depositories and participants. So accordingly, the correct option is B. So A and 2, B and 4, C 3 and D 1. So option B. Moving on to the next question. So before discussing the question, I would like to tell you that I have discussed this topic on our Telegram group also. So on our Telegram group, we regularly conduct quizzes and post relevant questions. Also, a lot of information, relevant information is being shared. So do join the Telegram group to get the benefit. The link for the same is provided in the description section below. Now, question 4. Two statements regarding depositories have been given below. So which of the following two statements are correct? So you are given two statements. So statement 1. Every depository is required to maintain a record of registered owners. So I have told you in question 1 also that there are three parties: company, depository and investor. So company needs to maintain a record of registered owner. And who is a registered owner? Depository is a registered owner. And depository needs to maintain a record of beneficial owners. And who is the beneficial owner? Investor is the beneficial owner. So statement 1 is wrong. Why? Because depository is itself a registered owner. So how will it maintain the record of its own? So basically, it is required to maintain a record of beneficial owners and not registered owners, because it is itself a registered owner. So this statement is wrong. And statement 2, securities held by a depository are dematerialized and fungible. So here there are two terms, dematerialized and fungible. So first of all, I will tell you the meaning of the two terms. So what do you mean by dematerialized? So dematerialized, basically, so you can understand it like this. So before the depository system, investors used to hold share certificates. So like they used to hold paper securities. So on the paper, it was written that the investor is the owner of the particular security or share. But after the depository system came, these physical securities now are converted into electronic securities. So there is no physical security, but only the record, right? And this record is maintained by depository. So dematerialization basically means conversion of physical security into electronic form. So this is right, that securities are held by security in dematerialized form. And second, fungible. So what do you mean by fungible? So earlier, when there were separate share certificates, so every share certificate had a different number, which give it a different identity. But after dematerialization, individual shares have lost their identity. So they have now become interchangeable. They have become interchangeable. So there is no distinct identity of any share certificate. So this interchangeability is called fungibility. So fungibility basically means to lose identity. So now the shares have lost their identity. So this statement is right because shares held by depository are dematerialized and fungible. So as we can see, statement 2 is correct and statement 1 is incorrect. So the correct option is B, only 2. Now moving on to the next question, question 5. A depository is required to maintain a minimum net worth every year and needs to submit audited net worth certificate by 13th September of each year. What is the minimum net worth requirement for a depository? So basically, SEBI, depository and depository participants regulations 2018, they talk about the minimum net worth requirement for a depository. So the regulation states that a depository is required to maintain a minimum net worth of 100 crore at every time, right? And also the depository is required to submit every year an audited net worth certificate. So an audited net worth certificate, so depository is required to submit an audited net worth certificate every year from a statutory auditor, and that too by 13th September, by 13th September every year. So this certificate will be for the preceding financial year, obviously, right? So what is the minimum net worth requirement? So correct option is option A, 100 crores. Now the final question, question 6. So this question is to be solved by you. I will not tell you the answer to this question. So you have to tell me the answer to this question in the comment section below. Then afterwards, I will post the correct answer. So let's read the question. A depository is a public limited company created as per Depositories Act 1996. The chairperson of a depository is elected from. Basically, depository is a public limited company and it is created under Depositories Act, which was passed in 1996. So the chairperson of a depository is elected from. So the options are shareholder directors, public interest directors, independent directors, executive directors and non-executive directors. So you need to post the answer to this question in the comment section below. So guys, if you learned anything new from this video, so do hit the subscribe button to get more updates and notifications. Have a good day.